Hello and welcome to the very first MotoGP Fantasy preview of the season. My name is Jack Gorsi and joining me here with also Luca Marini, who will bring onto the screen in just a moment's time. But of course, this is the first MotoGP Fantasy preview of the season. Then we do go racing in 2023 with the season kicking off in Portugal. The first time that it's kicked off in Europe in, 17 years since 2006. It's certainly a different flavour to the start of the 2023 MotoGP season. Of course, in this live, once we bring Luca Marini in, we'll be able to go through some of our MotoGP Fantasy choices and talk to you a little bit about the game as well. If you haven't signed up to MotoGP Fantasy, make sure you just head to fantasy.motogp.com and you'll be able to input your details there and start creating your team. So without further ado then, let's bring in our special guest for this first preview of the season, Luca Marini. And we'll say hello, Luca. A very warm welcome to you. How are you today?
Hi, Jack. Hi, everybody. Yeah, I'm fine. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be here.
No, it's good to see you. Of course, I'm sure that you're very excited to get going in Portimao. You've already had plenty of track time in Portimao with the test, but I'm sure that it's an exciting feeling to go on the track in a proper official session tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly. It's a completely different situation when we start the FP1. I'm really excited, and also start with this track is special because it's very unique and is amazing for his fast flowing corners and his up and down. It's very special to start here.
Of course, Luca, during preseason, you've been quite a fast boy out there on track. We know that you topped the Valencia test back at the end of last year. Then you were also fastest in Sepang. You didn't quite get the hat trick there in Portimao, but you were pretty close. And some are already tipping you as a bit of an underdog for preseason to come in and win some races and challenge quite well throughout the year.
Yeah, I try. I think that this season I can be one of the top riders. I want to be one of the protagonists of this new season, because the feeling with the bike is amazing this year, and also the team is improved a lot. We grow a lot compared to last season, and I hope that we can just improve during the season, session by session. Keep going like this, and with all the other different tracks that we're going to have this season, we can fight for the podium.
Well, I'm sure that you'll be able to, of course, in the sprint as well. We saw your sprint pace simulation was pretty impressive there at the Portimao test. But, Luca, we do have a job for you to do today, and kindly you've joined us and accepted it. We need you to help us choose who our lineup is going to be for the first MotoGP Fantasy round of the season coming up this weekend, obviously, in Portimao. So I'll give you a quick rundown of the game before we started this live. As you know, you have to choose four riders, two of which will be your gold riders who score 100% points, and then the other two will be your silver riders which score 50% points. And then of course you have to choose a constructor as well as a team. Of course you are a VR46 racing team rider and then also a Ducati rider as well, so I think I know who you're going to go for there. But so, Luca, before we kind of look at the prices of any of these riders, I think we've got a little bit of an audio issue there. Hopefully, it's not running the number one proudly on his motorcycle for the first time in his career, and also the first time in MotoGP that we've seen a number one since Casey Stoner a long time ago in 2012. He is most expensive, of course, as he did win that championship at $3.5 million. Then we go down all the way through the order in those championship scoring positions last year in 2022. And we actually find Luca is down here at 2.1. One thing this year, because it is going to be a little bit more difficult, you really do need to look down the order and kind of find some of the hidden gems in MotoGP Fantasy down here. Even guys like kind of Fabio Di Giannantonio at 1.8 million this year could be quite a good pick for some solid points. Raul Fernandez, another one at 2 million. Even Miguel Oliveira, of course, his home race this weekend. The home heroes won here before on a satellite bike, don't forget. And once again, back on a satellite bike this year. Luca, can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me? You can. Okay, perfect. So, Luca, we're going to get you to choose these riders then. So, first off, let's just ask you, who is coming to mind when you think of the top guys this weekend? Who do you think, which riders are going to be right at the front?
I think that Pecco is now the first rider that came in my mind because he made an amazing preseason. And it's really strong and fast. In all the interviews, you said that the new bike, 23 GP of the Ducati, is amazing, better than the last year bike. So it just can even stronger than last year in this moment.
Yeah, I mean, we asked you as well, Luca, and all the rest of the MotoGP riders who we thought the favourite was going to be back at the Portimão test the other weekend. And every single person said Pecco, actually. So Pecco, obviously, looking in fine form. So let's choose a rider then. So your first rider that you want to put in your team, Luca, who do you think that's going to be?
Pecco. My first pick Pecco. Is Pecco.
Okay, yeah. So we go Pecco. So the first rider is
I
Pecco.
I hope that's that we can have enough money for everybody.
Well, I hope so as well. As we already discovered, yourself is actually quite a cheap option. I think you're going to be very good this week, and I'm sure that you think that as well. So do you want to put yourself
you so
in
much.
As well?
Yeah, as a second pick, I put myself.
Okay, so we have two of our riders, of course. So now we do have 9.4 million remaining. We won't worry about that too much just yet. Now, your two silver riders, Luca, of course, these score only half the points that your two gold riders mm-hmm. score. But still not a bad idea to have some riders that you think are going to go very, very well indeed. So who, looking down this list, who do you think stands out as possibly a good choice? There's even your teammate here, Marco.
I want Miguel Oliveira.
Miguel Oliveira, certainly not a bad option.
Yeah, he rides in an amazing way in this track. He knows it very well. And with Aprilia, he can be one of the guys fighting for the victory.
He certainly can. So before we actually choose the last rider, Luca, because we know that your constructor and your team might be a very particular choice, should we fill those out first? So the constructor, of course, you can choose Ducati if you want to keep the bosses happy, or you could choose one else. It's completely up to you.
Help me to understand in which way this affect the points.
So, this is a good point that Luca raises. So how this will affect the points, Luca, is that the constructor points will be the average of the two highest finishing riders for that constructor. So, of course, for Ducati, you have 8 bikes out there on the grid. So it always gives you a really good chance to score good points. But even someone like Aprilia this year, as you say, you've already got Miguel Oliveira singled out as a good rider to have. You know, maybe Aprilia is not a bad
choice. I would like to pick Ducati, but I don't know if the money is enough. But for now, put Ducati. Then we will see.
So what we do have is 3.9 million left. Let's go and choose the team.
Okay, let's see our team. The price of our team.
Your team is 2.1 million.
Perfect.
Okay, so 2.1 million. Let's see what that leaves us with then. So it leaves us with 1.8 million. Now we're going to be right down the bottom.
Not
1.8
enough.
Million would give you Digia, Taka Nakagami, or Augusto Fernandez.
I want more money.
You want more money? Okay, so then that gives us the question of who are you going to remove from your team to get more money?
Difficult, eh?
Yeah, it is. It's tricky this year. There's a lot of thought that goes into it.
A different team with less money? No, impossible to one team with 1.9.
We can try. Let's have a look. There is Tecfrey at 1.8 or Rossini at 1.9.
No, so we can change Ducati as a constructor that is obviously really strong and really safe choice, but I want to put Aprilia.
Okay, so let's remove
because
Aprilia.
I need more money.
Let's hope your bosses aren't watching this live, Luca. So that gives us 2.4 million. So that will open up a few more options. So anyone from Alex Rins down?
No, I want Alex Marquez.
You want Alex Marquez? Where is Alex Marquez?
Yes, below.
Ah, yeah, 2 million. Okay, so let's put Alex Marquez in.
And 400k, we can take and spare each other, no?
Yeah, we can. It's either that or you can choose maybe a more expensive rider if you wanted to.
No,
or...
no, I'm happy like this. I'm happy like this.
Yeah? Okay, so
or,
it's not a bad team.
Instead of Miguel...
if we, you would be allowed 2.6 million. So that 2. Would be 6. Jorge Martin, Jack Miller, Jan Zarco.
This is
guys.
Difficult between Jorge and Miguel.
Mm. What do you think?
But I stay with Miguel. I stay with Miguel.
Okay, staying with the home hero. I like it. That's a good way to go.
Yes.
Okay, so your team then, Luca, if you're happy with it, is, of course, Pecco and yourself in gold riders. Certainly not a bad choice indeed. Then you've got in your silver riders Miguel Oliveira and Alex Marquez. Controversially, you've gone for Aprilia, but it's all right. We won't tell the bosses. It should be fine. And then, of course, you've gone for your own team, Mooney VR46 Racing Team, which... it's certainly not a bad option. Both yourself and your teammate Marco are looking very strong. So are you happy with this team then?
Yeah, I'm really satisfied.
Okay.
I would like to have a little bit more money for Ducati constructor, but it costs so much. So
it
we
does.
Need to save.
So one final question then before we go, Luke. It was a little bit of a tradition last year that we would ask whoever was on to kind of predict who we think was going to win the race this weekend. Of course, this year we have the sprint on the Saturday and also the main Grand Prix race on the Sunday. So if you were to choose someone to win those races,
two
either both, two predictions, please. Yeah,
okay.
Maybe it's the same rider. I don't know. But
Well, maybe it can be. But I think for sprint race, I choose Jorge Martin, and for the main race, Pecco Bagnaia.
Okay. Two good options. Interestingly, you didn't go for Jorge and the team. You kept Oliveira there instead. But anyway, we think he's going to win the sprint.
Yes.
Okay, Luca. Well, it's been a pleasure. Thank you very much for joining us and helping us choose our team
thank
here.
Thank you so
and
much.
Good
it was
luck
a pleasure.
This weekend.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Hope to see you soon.
See you soon, Luca. Thank you.
Ciao.
Okay, so that is going to be Luca Marini's team then. Sorry for the slight technical issues earlier on, but hopefully we got there all in the end. Anyway, of course, you can see there he's gone for Francesco Bagnaia, the reigning world champion, with the number one proudly on the front of that Ducati GP23. And then also himself, Luca Marini, which is definitely not a bad option. Luca, only 2.1 million, very cheap option at this stage, and someone that in testing everyone was tipping as a little bit of a dark horse coming into the season. Then, of course, he's gone for Miguel Oliveira, the home hero, certainly not a bad option either. Miguel was another one going very well in testing, even admitted himself. They think he's got top five pace, whether it's the sprint or the main GP race. So keep an eye on him this weekend. And then Alex Marquez, another man that's coming into 2023 in incredible form. He's gone for Aprilia, which this year is a better option than it was last year, purely because of the fact they have four riders rather than two. And then, of course, he's gone for VR46 Racing Team, the Mini VR46 Racing Team, which I think a lot of people playing out there watching on this live, you've probably got either that team or a slightly different one in there. Of course, if you're not signed up to MotoGP Fantasy, make sure you do. You can head to fantasy.motogp.com. You input all your details and then it will appear with a page like this. If anyone's wondering how it's going to work with the sprint points this year, you can head to the Help tab at the top of the Fantasy page. You scroll down, you'll see all the info that you need to know, how to play, all this sort of stuff. And then if you keep scrolling down past all of the league competition info, you'll see the point scoring and you'll see the points for qualifying Q1 and Q2, as well as then the sprint and the GP position. So you can see all of that info there. Also coming into it, I'm sure that if you're playing along with some friends in fantasy, you'll want to sign up to a league or at least create one yourself. You can just head to the leagues tab and you can join or create leagues there, and you can send a code to your friends to be able to join them and make sure that you do play along and see how well you can do, because there are prizes up for grabs once again. You could win a signed replica helmet from Pecco himself. Now that would be pretty cool. Or a Lenovo laptop, and then also an official MotoGP Tissot wristwatch, which would be very nice. There's also weekly competition prizes. You could win two MotoGP tickets to a GP of your choice if you are the highest scorer that week. So certainly not a bad thing to go for indeed. So that's going to be it then for us here, the first fantasy preview live of the season. Of course, Portimao is the first in a 21 weekend season here, MotoGP, more MotoGP than ever. And with the sprints on Saturday, it's really into unknown territory in 2023. Make sure you watch along this weekend. There is a video pass free trial that you can take advantage of as well to watch all the build up to this weekend's action. Make sure you go and do that and enjoy the weekend, and ciao for now.